Hello YouTube, so welcome back to my channel for some more Samurai Warriors 4 2. So previously we have seen Hisahide yet again becoming very comical about the whole ditch with the explosives, and of course Nobunaga just kicked his bum into it. Not surprising, huh? So we have the Nagashino's battle, which you know is the, I guess, anti-Nobunaga campaign that was called forth by what is left of the Takeda force, so let's do this.
ソンプ信玄公が亡くなられ、浅井長政も孤立して信長に討たれた。いいところまで行ったのだがな、実に惜しかった。だが、まだまだ逆転の機はあるぞ。我が輩が信長を戦場に引きずり出す。そこを無敵の武田騎馬隊で討ち取ってしまえばよい。
信長の鉄砲を恐れておいでかな。大丈夫。我が輩が信長の鉄砲を詰まらせておけば撃った途端暴発して自滅するわ。撤退か決戦か迷っておったが、久秀殿が暗躍してくだされば武田の勝利は固い。
信長様、鉄砲3000丁到着いたしましたぞ。これは信長様専用のものでございます。大尉久秀、試し撃ちは済みしか。
撃
てあの木の枝を撃ち抜いてみせよ。
いや、それは
信長様専用の鉄砲を撃つなんて恐れ多い。撃て。あ、そんな、ダメ。久秀、この信長をたばかりほふらんとしたか。許す。
信長は金ヶ崎の危機から見事脱出。久秀の目論みは再び外れてしまう。その後長政は甲斐の武田信玄と組み織田軍を追い詰めるが、運命はまたも信長の味方をする。間もなく信玄が病没し武田家は衰退。大きな後ろ盾を失った長政は 信長に攻められ自害した。その後信長は信玄亡き武田に徐々に圧力をかける。武田当主勝頼は逆転を狙い徳川領の長篠へ侵攻した。信長は同盟者である徳川家康を救うべく強固な馬防柵と3000丁の鉄砲を用意し、 自ら出陣。戦国最強と謳われた武田騎馬隊の戦法は鉄砲攻撃によりほぼ壊滅状態となる。信長の意に服し武田軍と戦わされる羽目となった松永久秀はその光景を歯ぎしりしながら眺めていた。
反逆の将、長篠の戦い。
Seriously though, what's up with Hisahide and his stupid plans of trying to, murder Nobunaga? Backfiring guns, man. And I wonder how could he even, survive all that crap? Of course, cheap Annie is gonna buy the ones on discount, even though I might not be even using them anytime soon. And, well, first of all, I'm gonna use him, which is you know, one of the hottest older guys. Yes, I'm a gerontophile. I guess Nobunaga always has been a very cool character, especially when Kosugi Jurota is the voice cast. But obviously, I don't know, maybe these like cooler villain dudes all have really weird, like, you know, Hisahide and Nobunaga have a colorful palette. Like, you don't have a fixed skill set or skill tree that you follow to, like, finish the whole hive. And you've noticed, man, like, in the first game when you play the new character, Masatora, his whole skill tree comes in a H shape. And this one actually looks like, Lengkon, like, I guess a lotus thingamajou. Anyhow, man, like, because I've been trying to play through the, I guess, the second battle for four times. So he is overly powered and his levels are totally enough to actually learn many of this. As you can see, I actually own almost 6,000 bucks, which is pretty hard to gain in, you know, this game, because first of all, my difficulty isn't that high. Second of all, I didn't usually spend a lot of time to finish the whole map and clear off every single officer and open every single case or box or anything to get the possible money income. So 6,000 bucks, man, just a solid proof that I have been doing no good. Not really no good. I didn't want to cheat, but my capture device just totally destroyed me. So yeah. So coming back forth, I don't know, it's just like you have so many extra weapons, so might as well just try to add some attack and, I guess, attack range. Yeah, so he's a slow character, so trying to make him more offensive when his attack do hit, it's gonna be cool. So yeah, since it has like level 20, so I'm just gonna try to update a bit. That's where all the money went. Yeah, I forgot totally that Nobunaga is a fresh character, so he's gonna start off with nothing. And the usual drill is I'm probably just gonna let the whole battle be in hands of Nobunaga. And, you know, like too many horses, I'll just try to, I guess, up the speed, because to me the speed is more important than the other, because some characters like, I don't know, like Katsuya as well as Hisahide is very slow. Oh my god, they look so good paired up together in the screen. Just, I don't know why. It's like evil people just looks good. And plus, I don't think Nobunaga is technically evil. He's just weird. Yeah, it's not wrong calling him the satanic leader, because he's kind of nuts, man. Like, people try to kill you. Oh yeah, try kill me more. Try kill me to death. Like, what the hell?
カール撃て。
Well then, I did not just edit out my voice on purpose, because there is a cutscene in the beginning of the battle. Come on, man, you know I have OCDs. I'm pretty sure, regardless of what I've said just now, I'll probably just cut the shit out, because, you know, it's a cutscene. Cutscenes should be immaculate. That's what I say. Oh yeah, speaking of which, I have to go back to Nobunaga, because he's literally level 1. I think him, pro... Well, I guess, like, not pro, but, like, post 4, after he went into this outfit, he's just instantly, like, 10 times more higher in the badass realist, because, damn, his, like, I guess his sword just glowing the characteristic Oda family's purple, and the evil purple aura is just so much making him a bigger badass, and he actually looks really handsome, well, at least compared to Model 3. It wasn't bad, but technically speaking, I think this one doesn't make him look like he had man boobs, because in the previous model, he has a relatively huge torso. I'm not really sure, does this one justify him of being a skinnier dude, but at least with I guess, the Dark Lord type of, like, this Dark Lord type of, I guess, armor that he's wearing. He actually looks not bad, and I like his little, I don't know, like, bat wings type of little cape thingy-majiggy that he's wearing right now, and of course he had the maniacal smile. And then now my subscribers would probably go like, what the F is wrong with you, bitch, because you have a very weird taste. You like crazy guys that self-destruct or blow people up and smile like a maniac. Now you like maniacal demon lords. I don't know, it's just character design. Just because I really like special and unique looking stuff, I guess that both of them fall into this category. And by the way, my favorite color is purple, so does it make more sense to you guys? Of course it doesn't, but it doesn't matter. Because still, I'm just gonna like them anyways. And yeah, basically what I'm gonna do right now is trying to keep Hisahide away from my, I guess, proximity, because he would probably just like clear off these normal, like, I guess, warriors and people, like targets, quickly. Because what I want to do right now, just like the level up I got just now, I want to make him at least level 10 so he gets to open up the second part of the skill tree. I might not be able to use him in the next battle because I have no idea. Eventually the Honnoji crap is gonna come and he's gonna be dead, so yeah. Those of you who played the previous generations, as well as who knows Japanese history, Honnoji, I guess the treason in Honnoji just like had him burned like a BBQ in the temple building. And of course, this infamous scene of shooting down the, I guess, the cavalry of Takeda. Which obviously, you know, like, it's so normal that of all the Asian countries back then, Japan's the first country to actually have, I guess, well, not really free export and import with European countries. I think the Portuguese people actually brought the, I guess, the first automated, like, guns. I'm pretty sure they're not like the modern day, like, semi-auto or totally auto rifles, but you get the point. They have rifles back then. We still have our little sticks and bones to beat people in the bumbones. I think it was like this whole thing happened in the 1940s. I think like, no, the 15,000. I think it's like it happened in AD 1500. Yeah, you call it AD 1500. Damn it. 2 a.m. in the morning, man, my brain is literally like jello. What I'm saying is that Nobunaga, okay. The only thing I don't like about him is, I just noticed now that his little armor actually have the muscle shape. I do hope that when he's stripped naked, which will never happen, that his body is not technically 8-pack, because that would look so weird. He looks like not so strong of a person, but his armor is like stenciled as an 8-pack, so yeah, that was another awkward conversation. But whatever, bringing back to the, what was I even talking about, man? Holy vanoli, man. Wow, Kosugi's maniacal laugh is just ridiculously creepy, just sending me chills up my back. What was I even talking about before all this? Yeah, like the guns and stuff. It's just like, yeah. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, 2 a.m. I usually forget what I'm trying to say in the midway of saying it. I was trying to rectify the fact that I actually don't usually make stupid mistakes like calling the year 1500 into 15,000, because we're not that ahead in time. And plus, we're no Doctor Who, we cannot time travel, so I'm not even sure if Earth still existed. Back to the game, talking about relevant stuff to the game. I guess the only thing I really just can't really get used to Nobunaga now is because his Musou attack, having him go maniacally, like frantically wave his weapon and just go slash and hack his way in whichever direction that you actually control with your, I guess, analog stick. But because from what I can see as an audience of this game, he hack and slashes way too quickly, so you sometimes, you know where you want to like hack the people down, but because he actually so frantically waved his shit, you would probably just go like, oh my god, I can't control him, and that's exactly the only drawback so far that I... But I remember his, like, Gokui, like, the one that you press down the right analog stick. Ah, wow. Maniac laugh. Like, this one actually doesn't need... Okay, wasting the total badassery with a really fucked up... You know, a very fucked up camera angle. Bad camera angles, man. It's really gonna hurt the game. What I'm saying, like, he is one of the... like many characters that I like to use just because his Gokui does not need aiming. I think like Yujimura also like just punches on the ground and then like waves of fire just like burn the people down. As well as I think right now like Nobunaga also had to plug the evil sword and a dark aura emits from him. It's just like to I guess Asian culture, well not technically Asian, in Japanese culture like a you know like a purple-ish color usually means, I guess, the underworld, like the world of the dead and evil. So there's a reason why, like, I guess Nobunaga's family, clan, his whole comrade of people actually wears purple. And his sword glows in an ominous purple. I'm not sure about the other countries, but I'm very sure, particularly in Asia and in Japan, like mostly, the color purple actually means like it's ominous. But actually in China though, I think most of the people think, I guess purple signifies power and wealth, and a lot of stuff that are evil or actually is ominous is in green. But it doesn't apply when you're actually doing the Peking opera, I guess color coding. Green in Peking opera actually means warriors, bravery, and sometimes even, I guess, like, chivalrous. But back to this, there's the reason behind all these purple in, I guess, his outfit and stuff actually is because purple in Japan means ominous, dark, evil, mischievous. So that's why also in Pokemon, any dark moves usually result in like a purple animation. Like Night Slash is like purplish black, and Dark Pulse, of course, is gonna be purple. So yeah, it's not gonna be a black pulse. It's like, what I think like the recent 3D generations actually had it in purplish black. So yeah. So this battle, because I think this had I not mistaken, this is like the third play through of any sort of Nagashino, and it's about time that I actually got, yes, finally, angles doing justice, people, and finally upgrading level-wise. So what I'm saying is, like, basically, Nagashino is one of those stages in this version of the game that I've been playing to death. And I'm pretty sure there's still, like, 6 freaking campaigns coming up, and I'm kind of expecting to see more of the Nagashino coming out, unless it's like totally not related to Nobunaga as well as the Takeda family. I'm pretty sure Nagashino is gonna show up at least one way or another. I would really like want to play some Kawa Nakajima battles because I really miss the Uesugi family, like Aya Gosen. Not so much of Naoe Kanetsugu because he's just always like, justice, and love, so yeah, not a big fan of that. But you know, like, Kenshin's pretty cool, and Aya Gosen is kawaii, and the new addition character of Uesugi, Kagekatsu. Yeah, Kagekatsu is very cute for a guy who has zero facial expressions. Like, if you play the Mercenaries mode for the previous 4, you can actually see like the very cute like animal loving side of him, and yeah, like when he's like playing around with the little kitty cat, he smiles. That's pretty cute. And of course he's voiced by Takeuchi Ryota, the very cool rock star-ish, totally gay-drained, unique Japanese hot dude. Oh my god, what's up with me and this particular episode going all like messed up in the brain? Alright, people are gonna go like, is that the real you? Well, not. It's more like I'm overly exhausted from 14-hour shift, and right now I'm just amplifying whatever the weird stuff that I learned from, I guess, the Asian and Japanese loving, beautiful culture that makes me kind of weirded out. But anyhow, so, like, I don't know, like, Kagekatsu as an addition to the OECD family is pretty fun. As I've told you guys about earlier in one of my playthroughs of this game, like, one of, I think, Hojo's son was actually sent to, I guess, the OECD family as a, not technically a fugitive, but as an adopted son. I think he's like Kakitora, so he's one of those characters, even in 4, that actually had his own character model, not the average-looking whoever dude I like in the game. So I might be expecting, like, the next, I don't know, next gen, the actual, like, sequel to this game probably would feature, I guess, Kagetora. Because, you know, UACB doesn't have a lot of people, so. Yeah, I get it, like, basically, Kenshin died of early age due to sickness, but, you know, like, they're of the, like, almost, actually, if you included all the events prior to the Warring States era, it's more than a century worth of freaking battling. I guess there is a lot of characters that you can actually exploit and make, because like the Three Kingdoms, there are so many awesome people in history, so hooray for your franchise, man. Like, just basically making money like a G. Like they always do, come on. Gaming industry. They make money like nuts. Oh, yeah. Like, let's be honest, Nagashino, man. Just like I said, this is one of those battles that I played to death, and the only, I guess, relief is that you get to play as different characters, and my whole quest of up-leveling Nobunaga is going on pretty well. Like, I think the few levels that I gained in this battle right now actually made a difference. Like, I guess him mowing down normal, I guess, officers are just, like, extremely easy-peasy now. Because judging from what I remember, his attack status wasn't that good, but, you know, I might be wrong. But I think he has, like, relatively high attack stats compared to, I guess, what's his face? Takeda Shingen, yeah. Because he used a very unique battle, I guess, fan, so yeah, I just love Kisahide's little charge attack. Because he's a pyromaniac and a, I guess, bomb expert, he usually have those, like, really cool hellfire. And, of course, they have to ruin it with this crappy angle. Them camera angles, though. I like how he stands a little bit like, what's his face? Zhang He. Because Zhang He's character, like, model bobs his whole body like that. If you kind of, like, remember, Zhang He actually wobbles with his claws, so funny. I guess it's just, like, me. I like Zhang He too, so yeah. Well then, here's another Swift battle. I'm pretty sure it's not Swift because if you add all the cinematics and all the 3D model chatting and stuff, it's gonna take a while, but, you know, we made it. Oh yes! More than 10 levels! Yeah, because I hope I actually get to play as Nobunaga in other campaigns. Or else it sucked, man. He's just here to play in this campaign and die.
Nobunaga wa wagahai ga Katsuyori wo takitsuketa koto wo minuite oru. Daga, sono ue de mata wagahai wo yurushita. Shaban wa mou ii, mou atakusan da! Yatsu wa mada jibun no unmei wa jibun no te ni aru to omoi konde oru rashii. Daga, sore wa wagahai ga sou omowasete oru dake. Nobunaga no unmei wa sude ni wagahai no mono. Wagahai wa wagahai no unmei wo tori modoshi ni kakaru.
Well then, I guess he's gonna finally come to the decision that he will go on a full-fledged, I guess, yeah, like I've expected. That's one of the major chapters in the Nobunaga, I guess, campaign from last game. He's gonna go on a full-fledged, I guess, rebel against our dear Nobunaga, and If I have not mistaken, he's gonna die in this battle, because that's what history said. But you know, like, it's gaming, so it's gonna have a twist. Well, I'll see you guys next time.